Hi, this is Kevin with GoDpsMusic, where we aim to inspire people to have music in their lives. We develop creative kits for musicians of all levels at the best value. Enjoy this great product video and make sure to share your ideas with us on Facebook, where you can speak directly with some of your favorite brands and receive some great deals and giveaways.
My name is Richard Patrick. This is Phil Buckman.
How you doing? We're in the band Filter, and we play the Zoom G3 and B3 pedals. And here we are in lovely Huntington, New York, about to play the Paramount with our good friends at Fuel. And Rich will be rocking that lovely G3 pedal. I will be rocking two of these B3 pedals on stage for our show tonight. This is how we get our sound.
I do some cool shit with this stuff.
He does some cool stuff with that shit.
Damn straight! The way I use the Zoom G3 is I actually use this as a noise gate, and then I use this one as a special feature, like one of the many effects I use. I use a ring modulator sound effect in a song called Dose. Then I have a big old 700 millisecond, 800 millisecond delay, just a big old dong, bong, bong, that kind of thing. And I have them all different. I have all different patches for every single song. For the song Skinny, I'll have an auto wah, which is amazing because I don't have to literally play the wah pedal with my foot because I'm not really good at it. So it's actually comes in handy. I love this thing because here's one of the most the ground issues you get in some of the places you play, like ground, the sound problems, the RF problems. Right here, boom, hit that, goes away. That's a huge big deal to me. Plus the DI is amazing. In the studio, I actually use the. Someone just flushed that. Okay. In the studio. I plug that bad boy in right there, and I use one of the many different amplifiers. And you can virtually simulate any amplifier you can think of. And for me, I'm the kind of guy that like I plug something in and I just find something and I move on. But there's a lot of people that like they want a Marshall sound or they want a British sound, and they want like a country sound, or they want like a Los Angeles rock sound, and you can find all that. And the other thing that you should know is that I actually have been using Zoom products for 15, 16 years. In fact, the baseline to Dose, we on the record used the demo because the demo bass sound was so good. So we actually used, as the entire bass tone on this one song is actually from one of these, an earlier version of one of these. So you can absolutely record with it. I use it live. I use it for a great many things, and it's got a lot of technology in it. It's got a lot of versatility, and I can't say enough how much I like it. So that's my thing.
I used two of these things live. I basically got rid of all of my pedals except for my wah, which was sort of custom made. So I keep my one wah pedal, but all the other pedals I had on my board I got rid of, and I used two of these. I go out of one into the other, and then out to my amp. first channel I'm using the Avalon D5, the DI5 simulator. Warms up the tone a little bit. Second channel I use for my distortion, it's based on the MXR DI-80, which was the pedal that I used to use. It sounds great out of the box. Next one I use is Chorus. I think it's just the regular Chorus, or is it the Vintage Chorus? One of the two. They're all good. I kind of go back and forth, actually, depending on the day. So that's one unit. I put the distortion and the Chorus next to each other because I'll go from a clean chorus sound to a distortion sound, and I just step on both pedals at the same time. One goes on, one goes off. On the next unit, the first position, I'm going backwards because I actually have them set up to go backwards. First position I use the ensemble preset, which is it's a very mild chorus, but it gives the bass a real warm, kind of open stereo tone. I use that for Take a Picture. After that, I use the analog delay for when I do volume swells, just to give it sort of a cello sort of effect. And then the last channel, I use reverb, the big, huge reverb. Because there's a couple of songs that we do where at the end of the songs, we'll hit open notes while we wait for the next song to start, and I have to change basses sometimes, so I'll hit that reverb, and it'll just keep ringing, and I can turn my bass off, switch basses, and put my next bass on, and hit the right note wherever I am, start playing again, and it's like I was playing the whole time, all the way through it. The sound is good, it's rock solid. I haven't recorded with it yet, but I'm looking forward to starting. I just started playing these things very recently, and so far I'm highly impressed, and I like them a lot.